Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 3.1, Problem 3. This is Section 3.1, Problem 3. It says, graph the linear inequality 3x plus 2y is less than or equal to 12. So to graph a linear inequality is a four-step process. Step one of the four steps is pretend that the linear inequality is just a linear equation, and find two points that make the equation true. So the way I do that is I make a little chart next to the linear inequality that I have to graph, and I have an x column and a y column, and I want to find an x, y value that makes this true if I'm pretending it's an equation. So the easiest value to deal with is if I let one of the variables equal zero and I figure out the other one. And I can put in other things than zero, but zero is by far the easiest. So if x is 0, the 3x becomes 3 times 0, and I'm pretending that it's an equation, so I'd be left with 2y equals 12. So if 2y equals 12, the value of y must be 6. 2 times 6 would make 12 equals 12. So 0, 6 is one point that makes the inequality true if I pretend it's an equation. Now to find a second point, next I will let y equals 0, and see what value of x I need to make this true if I pretend it's an equation. So if y is 0, the 2y in my linear inequality becomes 2 times 0, and it would basically just go away, and because I'm pretending it's an equation, I have 3x equals 12. And if 3x equals 12, x must be 4. 3 times 4 would make 12 equals 12. So I have two points that would make my linear inequality true if I pretend it's an equation. My two points are 0, 6, x is 0, y is 6, and 4, 0, x is 4, y is 0. So that's step one. I have two points that make my linear inequality true if I pretend it's an equation. Step two, plot those two points that we found in step one on a graph. And I happen to have a graph set up ready to go. So the first of the two points is 0, 6. X is 0, y is 6. So to graph that, I start from the origin, go over 0 and up 6, and here's one of the points right there. And the other point, 4, 0, if I start at the origin, I go over 4, up 0, and there's the other point right there, at 4, 0. So that's step two. Plot the two points from step one on a graph. So step two is good. Step three, connect the two points from step two with a straight line. Use a solid line if you have the r equal to in your linear inequality. Use a dashed line if you do not have the r equal to. We have the r equal to in our linear inequality, so I'm going to use a solid line, connect those two points. I'm going to use a ruler, so I get a pretty straight line. I'll put it on my two points. I'll hold it firmly, and there we go. So that's step three. I've connected the two points from step two. Step four, determine which half of the graph I should shade. Should I shade below that solid line or above it? So to do that, what you want to do is choose a test point that's not on the line. Use 0, 0 if you can. That's my favorite test point. 0, 0 is over here. It's not on the line, so I can use it. So take the coordinates of your test point. X is 0, y is 0. Plug it into the linear inequality that you have to graph and see if the result's true or false. So if I put in 0 for x and 0 for y, the coordinates of my test point, the result I get will be 0 is less than 12, which is certainly true. 0 is less than 12. So that means that my test point being down here giving me a true result means that the underneath side is the shaded side. So if I had chosen any point from the underneath side, it would have given me a true result. And any point that I would have chosen from the blank region, let's say I chose like over 8 up 3, it would have given me a false result. Like 15 is small and 12, which isn't true. So it doesn't matter which test point you pick, it's just that 0, 0 is very easy to use.